Hi everyone, welcome to the 14th video on Python learning series for network engineers. In this video, we'll see how to take device backup from the terminal to the machine where Python is running. I'll go to the previous script which we used. I'll copy the complete script. I have created another Python file called 10 underscore device backup terminal. I'll paste it here. Now, since we are going to use this script only for backing up the configuration, we don't need to open any file for commands. We'll give the commands manually here. So this I have demonstrated in the previous video, how to directly send command to the device terminal. So after invoking the shell, you need to give send, and you need to mention this as byte in Python 3. Then you can give the command here, terminal length 0. Then we need to give a slash n here, then show run also I'll give here, show run. Here we will increase the time delay to 5 seconds. Since it is going to be a running config, it is going to be bit lengthier, and based on the device performance and console outputs, you can change the time. Then after print statement, we are going to use open method here. One of the previous video I have explained about open method. So to see the details of open method, what you can do, go to Python interpreter here, help open. Yeah, so in that video I have mentioned the default mode is R means it will read the file, but here we are going to check both modes, like one is how to write and another is how to append the data to a same file. We'll be seeing both operations. Now I'll create an object called save underscore file equals open. File name I'll give RT router underscore, it is going to be a string, plus router IP we will be getting from here, the RTR variable RTR plus. Config, then comma, we'll give W so that it'll write the file. Then we'll see how append works. Next line is going to be save file dot write, then the same output we are going to write. So what we can do, we'll copy this output, then give it here, then tab save file, we need to close the file, so close. If you want to add to a different location, you can give the custom location here and it will save to that location. And in addition to this, after this we will see how to add timestamp in the file name so that you will be able to understand what time it took the backup. So now we'll try to execute this script and see. So it will be saving the script, the backup file also in the same folder itself. Python 10. Yeah, I'm getting the message saying that connecting to the device 10.10. Yeah, it saved the output in my same folder. Yeah, both outputs it has saved. Yeah, It has saved the complete output. 10 and 11. Now if you want to add the timestamp, you need to use the library called datetime. That is a default library available in Python. So for that, first we need to import the library. Import date time, then I'll call this as TNOW. You can give any name. Then date time dot date time dot now, it will print the current time if you give this command. So we'll see that from Python interpreter. We'll see the library date time. Yeah, so what they say, this is a fast implementation of date time type, and we'll search for date time. We can see some syntaxes here. Yeah, so we are using this format, and we will write one sample script in the interpreter. T now equals datetime dot datetime. Yeah, before that we need to import the library. So we'll import it. Import date time, then now if I give t now, I'll get the date and time in this format. If we want to convert this into the string format, print str tnow. Now we'll get it in this format, but it is adding even the milliseconds. If you want to remove milliseconds, what you can do, datetime.now dot dot replace, it is microseconds actually, micro seconds equal to 0. Yeah, we need to give microsecond. Now we'll print the time again. Now you can see without microsecond it has printed. We'll use this format. So for printing that, we won't use config here. So here we had config in the end of the file, we'll remove that. Here we'll add string of tnow. Save the script. We'll try to execute the script now. It is connecting to the device. Yeah. It is printed, but it is printed with microseconds. So we need to change that here in the script. So we'll do dot replace microsecond equal to 0. Save. We'll execute again. You can even skip this printing to the terminal if you want, and you can directly save it as backup. Just for confirmation, we are just printing it here. It is executing again. Yeah, here you can see now the output is without microseconds, and it is in a readable format with the file names. Now we'll see another option called append. Since we are adding time here, each backup will be having a unique file name, so we are going to remove this and see how the W and A methods in open function works. Because in W, you have seen W uses to write to a file, so it will be keep on overwriting the same file if you give W. If you give A here, it will append to the same file. So we'll see both actions. So for that, first we'll remove this TNOW so that each backup won't be having a unique name. We'll save the file and remove all these backups. Now we'll execute again. Yeah, now it is saved both devices output. So you can see I have full config here. I'll close this, or even if I open and keep it, it'll ask for update. If I change this to append now, we'll see what happens. If we change this to A and save, I'll try to execute the script again. You can see here file has been updated. So if I give reload now, you can see appended data here below. So this is the second backup I have taken, and it will be keep on adding to the same file. But if I give W now, I'll change this to W. And I'll execute again. Yeah, if I reload, it will have only one backup. Yeah, now it is having only one backup because it has rewritten the complete file. So I hope you understood the difference between write and append method in open file. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand how to take device backup. In the next video, I'll show how to take backup to an external server like TFTP, FTP, or SCP server. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.